Hey, I'm Tyler Shaw, and you're watching Stingray PausePlay.
I'm Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Stingray PausePlay here in Montreal with Canadian sensation, Tyler Shaw. Hi, Tyler.
How are you, man?
Good to see you. Welcome back. It's been like 3 years, 4 years since we had you on the show last.
It's been a while. Yeah.
You've grown up since.
I feel like, yes, last time I was here, I didn't have facial hair. Now I have facial hair.
Yeah, I don't think you had the ability to even grow a hair last time. So yeah, it's really, really good to see you back.
Yeah.
Growing up with Chinese culture and Polish culture and growing up in BC, how did those two cultures kind of play into your youth, if at all?
I wish it was more. At a young age, I was three or four when my parents actually got divorced. So my father wasn't really in the picture growing up. And that's why you're seeing the artwork on my new album, Intuition, of the Chinese influence. Because now my dad and I are, we have a great relationship and I'm finding out things of that side of the culture that I wish I knew back then. But now I'm just like so fascinated with it.
Like what are you learning and loving? I mean, I'm sure everybody loves dim sum.
Yeah.
But, you know, like what are the things like?
Like fashion, for example.
Oh yeah.
I love their fashion sense out there.
And speaking of your fashion sense has kind of grown exponentially since we last saw each other, not only on the stage, but in the streets. So as haute couture as you can be, you also have a known issue of your zipper malfunctioning on a fairly regular basis on stage.
Oh man.
Why do you think that's such a problem for you, Tyler?
I don't know. I actually have no idea why that happens.
Unfortunately, and my wife will attest, I'm in the same boat you are.
I don't know
why.
I do the button up, you know, everything's fine. Yeah. And then for some reason, it's just that extra step that I just can't get.
You just miss it. It sneaks off with that one sock in the dryer. If not an open zipper, what's the most embarrassing thing to happen to you on stage?
I guess forgetting lyrics is pretty embarrassing, which has happened, of course, but the show must go on, so you mumble something.
So do you mumble something? Do you make up something? Do you point it out that you screwed
up? I never point it out, but I always, if I don't remember the actual word, I'll phrase something that sounds like it. So like echo, I'd be like, echo, something like that.
Okay. So we asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question.
Okay.
The band is Stone Temple Pilots.
Okay.
And the question for you is,
if you could meet one person alive or dead, who would it be and why?
Oh my gosh. That's such a tough question. Cause like Elvis.
Yeah. Okay.
Prince.
Yeah. Okay.
Like there's so many.
So pick one.
You know what? As iconic as those people are, I don't know if I would go with a musician. Someone like Elon Musk would be very interesting to talk to see his sight on the future and talk about that.
What would be the first question that you ask him? You sit down at the table, he's probably already sparked a blunt. What are you guys talking about?
What's next?
Ooh, okay. Totally open-ended.
Just
I like it.
You
Not
tell
even
me.
What's next for humans, what's next in food, just what's
exactly.
next.
Exactly. He's like, I'm going to get my hair cut.
Yeah, it's like, I thought we were going to order dinner, but
exactly.
I guess, all right, that's good. The album's Intuition. You can really hear the maturity, the growth between album one and album two.
Thank you.
What's the biggest difference between 2015 Tyler and 2018 Tyler?
Oh my gosh. The major difference was I know who I am as an artist and as a person now versus back then. It was such a exploring time. Like I was like, what am I doing? What am I sound like? Who am I as a person and as an artist? So that was like trial and error of oh, that might sound cool. Oh, this might sound cool. But going into this album took me 2.5 years to write. And through those 2.5 years, I really like nailed it. I was like, this is what it's going to sound like and feel like. So that's the major difference.
The single's With You. It's such a great song. The
Thank
story
you.
Of meeting your now wife, kind of falling in love and kind of this, you know, true story, almost like you're just telling it to a friend. And the song kind of almost didn't happen, kind of a cancellation with a session and all this kind of interesting. So
right.
tell me what happened and how the song came up.
That song was written, my wife, we were just dating. It was just me, a boyfriend and girlfriend. And we were out in LA with me and my producer. And some guy canceled on us. I can't remember who the session was supposed to be with. But then we contacted one of our friends and he set us up with Neil Ormandy is his name. last minute, like the morning of, and like, okay, cool. Like we went in and magic was created. Honestly, it was such a fun session. You know, midway through the day, we had a ping pong break. It was great. It was a fantastic, fantastic day.
So how much of the song is accurate to actually have happened in life, and how much of it is storytelling?
So right off the top, it says running late on a Wednesday. It was actually a Saturday, but whatever.
Yeah.
Two hearts on a cold street.
Yeah.
We met in
you
Quebec
each
City.
Each have a heart, yeah?
Yeah. We met in Quebec City in the middle of March. So very cold place in two hearts on a street.
That's sweet, man.
Yeah.
It's a really nice song.
Thank you.
It's a really, really nice song.
Thank you very much.
Between the 2 years of working on this album nonstop, you get engaged, you get married, you don't really have a lot of off time, I'm sure.
Yeah.
What's your favorite thing to do that isn't music and you can't say soccer?
I love photography, actually.
Okay.
You know, whenever I go out, even if it's just to go downtown for a meal or just to pick up a garment or something, I'll bring my camera and shoot, you know, whatever it is, buildings, people, architecture, stuff like that.
I like that you said garment instead of piece of clothing.
Pieces of, well, yeah.
So your fashion sense steps up and you start saying the words like garment.
Garment,
I get
it.
Yeah, that's fine. Gold record holder, platinum record holder. What's the next dream milestone for you?
I think, at this point in my career, I would really love to see a Juno on my shelf. I think that would be fantastic.
I think it's about time.
Yeah, no, I'm, you know, I've worked so hard for this, last album, and I know I'm biased, but it's, I really feel like it's some of my best work. So I would be super honored to have a nomination and maybe even a win. So,
man, the album is fantastic.
Thank you.
You've really, truly grown so much since we last saw you. We're just so proud of where you've come. So
thanks so much.
Thank you so much for sitting down and chatting with me, man.
Of course,
I really
my
appreciate
pleasure.
It.
Thank you.
You can hear Tyler Shaw on Stereo Music's Hitlist channel and the Pop Adult channel. For a full list of the over 20 channels that we play Tyler Shaw, jump on our mobile app or our web player, find the magnifying glass in the corner, type in Tyler Shaw, and you'll get the full list. Thank you so much, Tyler, and we'll see you next time.
My pleasure.